when emergency services reported to a blaze on Alrick Avenue, Stonebridge, they found a horrific scene. One man lay unconscious outside of the home, and inside, Denise Keane-Simmons was found severely injured. Despite grave efforts to save her life, Denise passed away early that morning. But this was not a case of an electrical fault or an appliance that had been left on. Not only had the home been doused in petrol, Denise had been as well. The man responsible? He was the one found laying outside. The same man that Denise had been trying to get arrested for months leading up to the fatal incident. Denise Keane was an English graduate who worked for many years as a teaching assistant. She was a petite woman standing at just 4 feet 11 inches tall and was described by her family as a happy, fun, free-spirited, and charismatic individual. Denise loved her job and had a close bond with her family. Her first marriage ended after her husband was convicted of robbery and consequently deported. Denise was very close to her mother, who was married to the brother of famous musician Eddie Grant, who was a member of the Eagles and singer of Electric Avenue. Denise met Damion Simmons online in 2017 when he was still living in Trinidad. A year later, Denise flew out to the island and married Damion. Although it is unclear what Damion was like before the two were married, but after they had tied the knot, he began to show worrying signs. He didn't want Denise to go out on her own and would often criticize how she spent her own money, even though Denise was paying for his phone bill and giving him cash whenever he demanded. Damion wanted complete control over Denise and was jealous of her spending time with any other men. In December 2019, Denise's mother, Sally, passed away. At the wake held at her mother's home, Damion was drunk and began to take issue with Denise's former boyfriends being at the event and often yelled, "I'm the man of the house." After things escalated towards the end of January 2020, a violent incident led to Denise kicking Damion out of her London home and changing the locks. Police had been called at the time, so they were now fully aware of Damion's behavior. Denise had discovered the day before that Damion had fitted a hidden camera in her bedroom that were disguised as a light bulb. Since Denise would no longer put up with his behavior, Damion moved into his mother's house. Damion's mother's house was a one-bedroom flat with such little space that he had to share a bed with her. Following months saw Denise being bombarded with text messages and emails by her now estranged husband. On one occasion, Damion even showed up at her school. It was clear that he had no intention of leaving her alone, and in an attempt to humiliate Denise, Damion posted naked pictures of her on Instagram on April 15th, 2020, along with her maiden name, address, and the name of the school that she worked at. He also emailed her to tell her that he had posted images on a pornographic website. But that was far from the worst thing that he would do that night. While Denise called the police about the situation, Damion was on his way over to her place with a can of petrol. CCTV footage captured Damion buying a can of petrol at a station in Hornsea Rise. He then boarded a bus to Harlesden and hid near Denise's property. Officers arrived at Denise's home and stayed for about an hour. This incident has left me feeling emotionally drained. There seems to be no end to his behavior, and I do not expect a personal picture of mine to be published publicly. I feel anxious about leaving my house as his behavior is so unpredictable, and I just want to live my life without that worry of Damion. The officers left Denise with a 6-year-old friend who was going to stay the night. Roughly 30 minutes after the officers had left, Damion went to Denise's front door and began to pour petrol through her letterbox. After he was unable to set the fluid alight, Damion then smashed a bay window with a panel of wood to gain access into the home. Once inside, he proceeded to douse the home in petrol. He poured it through the living room, up the stairs, and on the upstairs landing. It was at this point that Denise had confronted him. The depravity that Damion showed next is truly unfathomable. Damion poured petrol over Denise's head and shoulders before setting his wife alight. And what Denise did next is truly heartbreaking. While on fire, she ran into her bedroom and locked the door behind her, which showed you how terrified she was of Damion. As fire began to rip through the house, Damion then decided to jump out the window to escape the flames. Denise's friend had been asleep, but she managed to jump from a bedroom window. Luckily, she did not suffer any serious injuries. Police were called at 2:15 a.m. after reports of a fire on Alrick Avenue. Damion was found lying on the ground beneath the bathroom window. He reportedly told paramedics, "Just let me die." firefighters struggled through the flames to reach Denise, and they found her curled up next to her bed. She was rushed to the hospital, but tragically Denise lost her life at 6:07 a.m. from the severe burns and smoke inhalations. She was just 36 years old. Police immediately treated the fire as suspicious, and Damion was arrested on the scene. He was taken to the hospital to treat his minor burns before being taken into custody. During their investigation, police found two images that had been taken on a hidden camera when they examined Damion's phone. He also reviewed the items saying, "Faulty, works okay, runs out of charge quickly." He justified this by saying that he hoped the camera would help them save the relationship. He said he purchased it to see who she was talking to, you know, so that I can try and salvage my mirrors because I knew a lot of people are talking to her. On April 30th, 2 weeks after the fire, Damion was officially charged with Denise's murder. He was also charged with arson with intent to endanger life, criminal damage endangering life, and sexual photographs with intent to cause distress and voyeurism. Damion was kept in custody until his trial in August 2021. At the trial, Damion admitted to being a controlling and jealous husband, but he claimed he didn't intend for Denise to die that night. Damion put forth a story that he wanted to die in front of Denise, but when he went to pour the petrol on himself, she knocked the can from his hands. An expert witness told the jury that, after looking at Denise's post-mortem results, her injuries were consistent with petrol being poured over her and then ignited. Denise had suffered burns to 60% of her body. The jury also listened to how Damion had set up the spy camera in Denise's bedroom and about the recording equipment he had installed so that he was able to listen to her conversations. Unsurprisingly, Damion was found guilty of manslaughter, which he himself had admitted to. Damion was sentenced to 32 years in prison by Judge Philip Katz. At his sentencing, Judge Katz told Damion, "It was your own possessive and controlling conduct towards your new wife which destroyed the marriage, not the efforts of people close to Denise whose only concern was her welfare." Denise's aunt read out a victim impact statement saying, "Words cannot truly express how devastated we are. It is a pain that is indescribable and one that we will never forget. Denise has so much more to offer the world, but unfortunately she was taken away from us way too soon." The defendant has not shown a single ounce of remorse throughout this trial. All he has thought about is himself, and we as a family truly believe he was fully aware of his intentions that night he set the house on fire. After hearing the verdict, Detective Chief Inspector Neil John said, "This type of behavior unfortunately epitomizes extreme domestic violence. And I would urge anyone who feels they may be in such a relationship to contact the police or partners who will be able to take a positive action and provide necessary support and advice." He went on to condemn Damion for his actions and comment on the type of person it was clear that Denise was. "But Denise had contacted the police about Damion's behavior, and I'm not referring to the night of the murder." Denise had been first in contact with the police on January 26, 2020, after that violent incident with Damion. A few days later, they had to remove Damion from the home after he had locked Denise in her room. That same day, she had found the spy light bulb, which led to her to call the police again. PC Sandy Kunkun was assigned to the case and given an action plan by her superior. She was tasked with contacting Denise to see if she would support a prosecution, to which Denise said she supported fully and wanted Damion to be arrested. However, Damion was not arrested on February 13th. Denise contacted police and told them that Damion was harassing her via email and posting lies about her on social media. She reiterated that she wanted Damion to be arrested and that she would willingly attend court if need be. After Denise's murder, the Independent Office for Police Conduct launched an investigation into the handling of her case and found that Ms. Kunkun had canceled 3 interviews with Denise and not doing sufficient work into the case before setting it all to be closed on April 6. 10 days later, Denise was murdered. After investigation concluded, a disciplinary panel decided to fire PC Sandy Kunkun for a shocking dereliction of her duties. Denise's story is sadly far too common. She was a bright woman whose future was snatched away from her by an abusive man that, despite her best efforts, she was unable to stay away from. Our thoughts and prayers are with her family.